Jeffree Star really just got exposed by Gabby Hanna, all thanks to Shane Dawson's big mouth. Things just aren't looking good for anyone at this point. Hello and welcome back to Drama Investigator. In today's re-spill, we're going to be covering Gabby exposing Jeffree Star, Blair White and Shane Dawson's podcast resurfacing, and Jeff Whittick just exposed he's being blackmailed. The tea is getting so hot, you guys. Time to pour a cup of this juicy brew and get into it. Peter Mon alleged in a video recently that Gabby Hanna allegedly told him that Shane Dawson allegedly told her that Jeffree Star allegedly still uses language in everyday conversation. Peter also added in the video that he hopes Gabby includes that in the series that she's working on. Now, it's interesting because the main reason Gabby decided to expose Shane was because Shane went behind her back apparently and did something, I'm not 100% sure, but I saw somewhere that she wanted to go on a date with someone Shane knew about, and then Shane linked that person up with someone else, which upset Gabby, allegedly. But who knows, honestly. Shane also allegedly told Gabby Hanna that Trisha Paytas has her. And Gabby, as we all know, went off and told the whole world about that. Now, as we all know, Gabby is currently trying to start drama with Trisha Paytas. She won't stop going off about Trisha and how she alleges Trisha and everyone else on YouTube is a narcissist and a bitch. Trisha, however, is really not that bothered by what Gabby has to say. Leading on from all the videos Gabby has made about Trisha recently, trying to expose her, Gabby also uploaded a couple more videos to TikTok with leaked messages between the pair, which Trisha actually recently debunked.
As far as Thanksgiving, I wasn't exactly right. You just said that you were gonna stay home and that you should have, and we could have just eaten together. So no, you didn't invite me to Thanksgiving, but I got that fact a little bit mixed up because that's what happens when somebody that you haven't been friends with for a long time keeps dragging you into their mess online. So sorry, I misremembered. I was thinking about this. Sorry about that. But since I was looking through all of our conversations from 2016 to 2019, I thought it would be fun to show everybody the friendship that you said didn't exist because you didn't know me, right? Despite the fact that I have years of text messages saved between us. I don't know why you lie like this. You're a really, really mean, malicious person. Like, what are you so afraid? Well, I know what you're so afraid of, and so will everybody soon. I'm actually really happy you brought this up because Trisha herself has been upset since 2017 that the internet didn't know that we were friends. We're not anymore, obviously, but her story is that we were never friends and that she never knew me, and that I'm delusional and imagined a friendship. And I think that's up because it is. She could have just left me alone, but she doesn't. She keeps talking about me. So if you're gonna keep gaslighting me to the world, saying that I'm delusional and crazy and created a friendship in my mind, well then I'm just gonna show our friendship. Coming soon. Make sure you subscribe to The Gabby Show.
Trisha then posted funny videos to her TikTok in response, basically taking the piss out of Gabby's exposing videos.
I still really like you.
I don't like you at all.
Really?
Yeah. Like, I think you're, like, funny, and I think you're, like, a charming person. We're face-to-face, so I'm being nice to you, but, like...
So yeah, Trisha is obviously not bothered at all with anything Gabby has to say about her. Now, just when you thought Shane Dawson couldn't get exposed anymore than he already has, a podcast has resurfaced of both him and Blair White discussing non-binary and trans people in an offensive way. Shane literally asked if trans people have a mental illness.
I found the podcast episode with Shane Dawson and Blair White a couple of days ago, and here are some of the highlights.
There's people who call themselves non-binary, which is people who don't think they're either or, which is like... I'll let you figure that out, but you're not a third gender just because you don't know what you are.
Right. It's interesting that some of these trans people online are so offended by everything, which makes me think, like, what? Like, like you say, you've been through so much. Like, you're not offended by somebody accidentally calling you. Who gives a Literally, who cares? Is it a mental illness? Because technically, that might be what it is. But then some people are like, well, is being gay mental illness? I'm like, maybe. I don't know. Like, but it is something where I'm like, oh, is this just like... their way of dealing with their issues is like putting labels, which I guess that's fine. And then I've had friends come to me being like, young people being like, I think I'm trans. And I'm like, I don't think you, yeah, I'm like, that's a huge decision. And also I feel like you think about it your whole life. I don't think it's something that pops in your head at 18. You know what I'm saying?
No, none of these people who claim to be trans who use like they and them and all that, they never actually transition.
Blair White has yet to make any comments regarding this podcast, and Shane obviously hasn't said anything. He doesn't go on social media at all. In fact, the last time he popped onto his Instagram story was to share an emotional message about his mental health.
Hey guys, I pulled my back. Again, I keep doing that. I don't know why.
But I just wanted to say hi, hope you're doing good. Hope you're, I don't know, not as panicked, even though things are still really bad. Probably worse than they were yesterday. I feel like, it almost feels like, since I posted that and I've seen how you guys are feeling, I almost feel like, I don't know, it feels nice to know everybody's, a lot of people are in the same mental headspace, so it's like, okay. So, hope you have a good day, and yeah, keep your head up. I'll try to keep my head up. It might fall off, but I'll try. Okay.
So yeah, we probably will never hear anything come out of Shane's mouth about this podcast. Jeff Whittick recently alleged that he was blackmailed with his accident footage. For those of you who don't know, Jeff Whittick recently opened up in his tell-all documentary series about a stunt he tried for a vlog last year that left him severely injured. And David Dobrik was the one operating the excavator that Jeff was swinging from. Jeff has now alleged that he was blackmailed with that accident footage. Winnie Pope was associated with the vlog squad, not entirely sure who she is exactly. Well, she recently denied at Jeff's allegations that she was blackmailed Jeff with the footage. She recently allegedly tweeted, "Jeff Whittick, time to be honest. You were never blackmailed. $40? You're such a liar. Just trying to be honest with everyone. You should feel like such a dumb. You knew how unsafe it was. Don't put your trauma on anyone. Own up to your lies. Man up." There's also been some screenshots circulating that show Winnie being asked for money for the video. "Do you have the video of Jeff's accident? Willing to pay money? Yes, I do. I'm not interested in your money though. Would you ever release it? Most likely no. It just depends on if he ever decides to eventually talk about it. That's fair. Thanks for replying. I'd sell it now. Insider is interested." What? So I'm not sure at what point she allegedly blackmailed Jeff Whittick, but someone took screenshots from a Reddit account recently that were under her name, responding to users who were making comments about the situation. It's not known, however, if this user is actually Winnie or not. It could just be a fake account, but some people are pretty certain from some of the responses it's allegedly her. Someone had said, "Assuming this isn't a fake account, if you want the rumors, etc. to go away, then stop inserting yourself into the narrative. No one knew about your family until you and your daughter started kicking up a fuss. I wish you were right. I've been getting messages since the day we took him to the hospital. Probs isn't that big. People saw us at the ER. I'm okay with people knowing what actually happened. I don't want people to think that we are these awful people trying to make money off a near fatal accident. Small town gossip would have just faded away if you just let it. But instead, you made accounts on multiple social media platforms, posted leaked footage on TikTok, and responded to DMs. You put a spotlight on your family. Stop drawing attention to yourself, and I promise you'll fade into irrelevancy real fast. You're most likely right. Someone sent me a message because I literally haven't seen anything anyone else is saying, except for the people who make the fake Instagram accounts and leave disgusting messages. Like I said, people do know my family was involved, and I promise you that you wouldn't want to be accused of doing something you didn't. Can you explain the screenshots circulating where you say you are willing to sell the footage now that Insider is interested?" "Yeah, someone offered money. I told them no. When Insider asked for it, I said I'm not giving you the footage. She said, well, we don't normally pay for stories. That was the last thing she said, and I haven't talked to her since. Stupidly, I messaged back the person who said they would buy it and said I'll sell the video. Insider is interested in it. Jeff and I weren't being nice to each other. My emotions got the best of me, and I truly regret those words. If you were there, why didn't anyone say that swinging from the rope was dangerous? Why did anyone let David operate and do so recklessly? I've done that exact thing and never would put myself or my friends or strangers in a position like that. I'm sorry you were getting shit from people. Maybe it'd be wise to private your accounts for now, until the drama passes." He never specifically mentioned it was you or your family blackmailing him, but the internet can be reactionary. This was David's video. He wasn't going to stop, and the owner of the excavator was there. I think they were just having fun, and nobody was really thinking about what ifs. That's fair. Doing stupid things safely has just been something drilled into me. That's why I'm still baffled by it. If the comments from others are bothering you and your family, maybe it'd be best to private your account though, and maybe just call Jeff to talk about it. I don't know, but I feel for you. Thank you. I know it will all blow over. It's fresh right now, and I don't mind answering questions. It's weird to think that someone you don't know could say something and actually have it hurt a little." So, what are your guys' thoughts on all this drama? Let me know in the comments.